Dear students, today's topic is isomerism in coordination compounds. Isomerism is quite common in coordination compounds, dear students, and they are seen to exhibit both type of isomerism, like structural isomerism as well as stereoisomerism. Dear students, the structural isomerism, as you know very well, it is due to the fact that when two or more compounds, they have same molecular formula but possess different structural arrangement. So same situation is seen in the coordination complexes as well. So structural isomerism and coordination compound is of five types. I have listed out here, like first is ionization isomerism, second is hydrate isomerism, then we have linkage isomerism, then we have coordination isomerism, then we have ligand isomerism. So we'll talk them about one by one. So we'll start with the ionization isomerism first. Ionization isomerism is seen in the coordination compounds when two or more coordination compounds, they have same molecular formula, means their components are same, atoms are same, but they differ in terms of their ionization behavior and furnish different type of ions. I'll take example of two complexes here. So you can say here it is tetraamine bromido cobalt 3 sulfate, and it is tetraamine sulfato cobalt 3 bromide. In these two complexes, all the atoms are same. Both of them, they share same molecular formula. But if we dissolve them in water, in solution, this particular compound furnishes positive ion as pentaamine bromido cobalt 3 and negative ion as a sulfate ion. But when this compound in solution provides pentaamine sulfato cobalt 3 ion and anion as the bromide ion. So in spite of having same molecular formula, the ions furnished by these two complexes are different. The solution of this particular compound gives white precipitate with barium chloride due to the presence of sulfate ion in the solution. Whereas this particular compound in solution form gives pale yellow precipitate of silver bromide with silver nitrate solution. It is due to the fact that bromide ions are present in the solution. So this way, two compounds can be identified to have ionization isomerism between them. Now moving on to the next isomerism, that is hydrate isomerism. Dear student, hydrate isomerism is due to the fact that water molecule can act as ligand as well as simple molecules of water of crystallization. So when we have two or more complexes which are differing on that basis, means in one of the complexes water molecule is a ligand, in other complex it can be as a water of crystallization. So when such coordination compounds are found to have hydrate isomerism. So I have here three examples, you can see them, 1, 2, and 3. Look at the first example. It is hexaequa chromium 3 chloride. This is pentaequa chlorido chromium 3 chloride monohydrate. It is tetraequa dichlorido chromium 3 chloride dihydrate. In all three complexes, if you see here, then you'll find the basic difference of the water molecule and its behavior. In the first compound, 6 water molecules are acting as ligand. In the other compound, which is having exactly similar molecular formula, but the difference is in terms of water molecules, here 5 water molecules are ligand, whereas 1 water molecule is as water of crystallization. In the third example, you can see here, out of 6 water molecules, 4 are as ligands, whereas 2 are as water of crystallization. So this becomes the criteria of the hydrate isomerism. Dear students, now we are moving on to the third isomerism, that is linkage isomerism, which is also known as structural salt isomerism. Dear students, this isomerism is due to the presence of MB-dentate ligands in coordination compounds. Remember, MB-dentate ligands. MB-dentate ligands are those ligands which can attach themselves to the central metal atom or ion via one atom and in other case via other atom. Like here, in these two complexes which have same molecular formula, they have MB-dentate ligand nitro here and here nitrito. In this complex, you can see here, NO2 is attaching itself to the chromium ion via nitrogen atom. In this example, NO2 is attaching itself to the chromium ion via oxygen atom. So when two or more complexes of this type which share the same molecular formula, they have the same ligands as well, but due to the presence of MB-dentate ligand, they differ in terms of their mode of attachment, then the isomerism exhibited by the coordination complexes is called as linkage isomerism. We can verify this isomerism via the IUPAC name of the coordination complexes as well. Like the IUPAC name of this complex I have written here, hexaamine nitrochromium 3 ion. Whereas of this is hexaamine nitritochromium 3 ion, which clearly shows the difference in the atom via which NO2 group attaches itself to the chromium ion. Now we have the next isomerism, dear students. It is coordination isomerism. It is a very special kind of isomerism and is shown by such coordinate complexes in which both cation and anion are complex ions. So this is the primary condition to have the coordination isomerism, that both cation and anion should be complex ions. In this type of isomerism, it is due to the interchange of ligands between coordination spheres of positive and negative parts. Like you can see here, I have this complex here and this complex here. If you look at both the complexes, they share the same molecular formula, their components are same. Only the difference is its positive sphere. The first complex positive sphere is composed of cobalt and amine as the ligand, whereas in this complex the positive sphere is composed of chromium and amine as the ligand. In the first complex, the negative ion is composed of chromium and cyanido as the ligand, whereas in the next complex the negative ion is composed of cobalt and cyanido as the ligand. So you can see here, in this kind of isomerism, the complexes differ in terms of their ligands between the spheres of positive and negative ions. Now we have the last isomerism, which is known as ligand isomerism. This is a very special case of isomerism, and it arises when the ligand present in the complex can exist in more than one isomeric form. The best example for this is, I'll write the formula of the ligand, CH2, single bond CH, single bond CH3, this CH bonded with amino group, this CH2 also bonded with amino group. This compound is known as 1,2-diaminopropane, which in short is represented as PN, the short abbreviation. Now this ligand can have its isomeric form, which can be written as CH2, CH2, single bond NH2, single bond CH2, single bond CH2, single bond NH2. Now if I write the name of this ligand, it becomes 1,3-diaminopropane, which in short is represented as TN. So when ligands are same, but the ligand has different isomeric form, then the isomerism is known as ligand isomerism. You can see here, cobalt is bonded with 1,2 diaminopropane as well as 2 chloride ligands. And in this complex, cobalt is bonded with 1,3 diaminopropane and 2 chloride as the ligand. So, ligand isomerism is due to the presence of such ligands which itself can exist in more than one isomeric form.